A special thank you to each of our subscribers who make this channel possible. Here's today's story. In a significant development for Scotland's sporting landscape, the Scottish government has officially accepted a scaled-down version of the Commonwealth Games, set to take place in Glasgow in 2026. This decision comes on the heels of a substantial financial commitment from Australian authorities, aimed at rescuing the event after the state of Victoria withdrew as the original host due to soaring costs. The decision marks a pivotal moment in the Commonwealth Games history, particularly as it comes just 12 years after Glasgow last hosted the Games in 2014, an event that left a lasting legacy in the city. The announcement was made following a meeting of the Scottish Cabinet, where Health Secretary Neil Gray met with representatives from Commonwealth Games Australia and Commonwealth Games Scotland. The Commonwealth Games Federation, CGF, has pledged nearly £100 million, £200 million Australian dollars, from the compensation owed to them by the Victorian government, which totals £380 million Australian dollars, after Victoria's abrupt withdrawal in July 2023. This financial lifeline has been welcomed by both the Scottish and UK governments, who had expressed concerns about the viability of hosting the Games amid rising costs and the need for public funds. Gray emphasized the importance of ensuring that the event does not pose any financial risk to the government, stating, "Our financial resources are limited," and acknowledging the need for a model that minimizes costs and maximizes accessibility for future hosts. The proposed Games will feature a significantly reduced format, with only 10 sports being showcased compared to 18 in 2014. This streamlined approach is designed to align with the CGF strategy to make the Games more sustainable and accessible for future hosts, potentially paving the way for more cities to consider bidding for the event in the future. Ian Reid, chair of Commonwealth Games Scotland, expressed his enthusiasm for the government's backing, noting that Glasgow's world-class facilities and experienced workforce make it one of the few cities capable of delivering the Games on time. He stated, "This is a really exciting opportunity, and we will be working hard over the coming days to bring the final pieces of the puzzle together." The event will utilize just 4 venues across the city, without the need for an athlete's village, and any opening and closing ceremonies are expected to be significantly scaled back compared to the elaborate productions of the 2014 Games. The total budget for the 2026 Games is projected to be around £114 million, $222 million, with assurances from organizers that public funds will not be required to cover the costs. The UK government has also committed to providing financial support in the event of heightened security threats, although it has refrained from fully underwriting the Games. The decision to host a scaled-back version of the Commonwealth Games has sparked a mixture of excitement and concern among local politicians and community leaders. While many see this as a golden opportunity for Glasgow to showcase its capabilities on an international stage, others have raised issues regarding the current state of the city. Scottish Labour leader Anas Sarwar has voiced concerns about the city's neglected appearance, stating that it should not take major events for the local council to address issues such as dilapidated buildings and urban decay. Sarwar, who aims to become the first minister in the next Scottish Parliament elections in 2026, hosted a summit with local business leaders to discuss the potential benefits of the Games, emphasizing that it could serve as a platform for Glasgow to demonstrate its capacity for leadership and regeneration. He described the opportunity as a no-brainer for the city, asserting that hosting the Games could help complete the legacy of 2014 and present Glasgow as a window to the world. The CGF president, Chris Jenkins, highlighted that the agreement to host the 2026 Games is a crucial step towards a new model of the Commonwealth Games, one that prioritizes financial sustainability and accessibility. He noted that the investment from the CGF, combined with the contribution from Commonwealth Games Australia, will enhance the delivery of the Games and ensure they are a success. The collaboration between the Scottish Government, Commonwealth Games Scotland, and Commonwealth Games Australia has been described as positive and productive, with both sides working diligently to finalize the proposal. As preparations begin, there is a palpable sense of anticipation in Glasgow, with many looking forward to the return of the Commonwealth Games to their city. The event promises to not only deliver an exciting sporting spectacle, but also to generate economic opportunities and boost local morale in a city that has faced its share of challenges in recent years. While the 2026 Commonwealth Games may not mirror the grandeur of its predecessor, the commitment from the Scottish government and the financial backing from Australia signal a renewed hope for the future of the Games and the potential for Glasgow to shine once again on the international stage. As the city gears up for this scaled-back event, the focus will be on creating a memorable experience for athletes and spectators alike, while ensuring that the costs remain manageable and do not burden the public purse. In conclusion, the decision to host the 2026 Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, albeit in a reduced format, represents a significant achievement for the Scottish government and a testament to the city's enduring reputation as a capable host for international sporting events. With the support of the Commonwealth Games Federation and Commonwealth Games Australia, Glasgow is poised to deliver a successful event that will resonate with both participants and fans, reinforcing the city's legacy as a hub of sporting excellence. That's all for this story. We upload videos every day covering many different subjects, so hit that subscribe button to stay informed. Thanks for watching.